Hey everybody, hope you're having a great day, and today I am doing a review as I picked up a pair of the Hoka One One Bondi 5, and I didn't even realize that it was pronounced One One. I always thought it was 1-1, so it is pronounced One One, and I had also gotten a pair of the Clifton 4s as my first pair, and then I got these right behind those, and been so pleased as a Hoka customer, and I look forward to sharing with you my experience about the shoe. So I actually got it, today is a Tuesday evening, I got these on Friday, wore them over the weekend, got to run on the treadmill, and wore them at work, so I really got a good feel. Oh, and most importantly is I also climbed Stone Mountain, and it was so beautiful on top, as you can see here. Just been a good experience. Took a little bit more to get used to these than the Cliftons, but I am becoming more and more of a fan of the Bondis. So these are, retail price point is $150. And, you know, this is quite a shoe. This is like a tank. It really is. I mean, look at that sole. That is amazing. And, you know, when you first put them on, it almost feels like clogs, you know, like big shoes. But they really make it for a nice experience. Let me first share with you some highlights from the site. It shows stability is moderate. Cushion is plush. Its heel to toe drop is 4 millimeters, and the weight for the US 9 is a 10 ounce, and it's best for the road. It comes in a number of different colors. These, by the way, are a wide, so I got an 11.5 wide, and I also got a very thin running socks, because even though this is a wide, the toe box I felt was still a little bit narrow, and when I got these thin socks, you know, that was perfect. So as far as the details, it's got a full EVA midsole and provides a signature Hoka One One cushioning. It has moderate heel bevel, which provides smooth heel transition, and 3D puff print frame, lightweight detail support, zonal rubber placement for durability that you can see there. So here, this is a more durable rubber, this is softer, and the combination of the two makes it for generally a nice experience. The women's weight, by the way, is 8.5 ounces, and that's based on a US size 7. And so there's more details, and you can click on the link where you can order these. So a couple of things as well, there's reflections on the side and on the back, so you get it here. You get it on the back here, and also the Hoka lights up. So very comfortable shoe. They are not, I mean, for some people might say, wow, they're heavy, but they're really not too bad. You know, I'm pleased with them. I do, you know, I'm getting used to this color. It wasn't my favorite color, but I was able to make it work, and now I'm really starting to like them. By the way, on the insole, this is the insole, Hoka One One Neutral that you got there. I didn't feel as much when it comes to arch support, didn't feel as much there in the arch support, but although I need the arch support and I've had plantar fasciitis issues, I'm doing well. I still feel a little bit of my heel. My heels have been a little sensitive, but doing a whole lot better. So, again, it's got a nice look to it, nice design. As far as cushioning, what's really amazing about the shoe, it's a little bit more firm than I thought, but when I'm walking, you almost don't even feel like you're hitting the ground. It's the absorption that these take is really fantastic. And as I mentioned earlier on, that I climbed Stone Mountain with these, and on the flat surfaces, it did well. Because I wore thinner socks when I was climbing up the hill, I felt like my foot was leaning in the back of the shoe going down. I could feel like it was really pushing to the front of the shoe, but I did well, and my heels were bothering me when I did get to the bottom of the hill, or the mountain, Stone Mountain. So funny, it's not a mountain, it's a hill. So if you have a chance, look up Stone Mountain. But it's a nice walk up, 25 minutes up, about 25 minutes down, give or take. And so my heels were bothering me, and I came home and iced. And normally I would be in a lot of pain even the next day, but these really helped reduce the amount of pain that I've had. I've really enjoyed wearing them at work. And I also ran on the treadmill, as you can see here. I ran for a little over a mile just to see how I did, and I was doing well for a while. And a little, again, it's just my heels are adjusting, but this is me on the treadmill. As far as the shoelace, it does have a stretch material, nice design shoelace as well. The shoes didn't feel like I was sweating too bad or it got too hot, maybe a little bit. The tongue holds well. But all in all, I am pleased with this shoe. If you are looking for a shoe to be on your feet, if you're going to go long distances, at first I was like, man, these might be just too much to run with the, because they were so big and I felt like overwhelmed when I first put them on. But as I've gotten used to wearing them, the more I like the fact of how they feel when walking and running. You really just don't feel the pounding on your feet. And for me, that is key. So my feet are definitely doing a whole lot better, and especially since I've switched now to the Hokas. So click on the link where you can get more information on the shoe. Please let me know if you have any questions. If you are wearing these, feel free to leave any comments below. But nice job, Hoka. And looking forward to, getting a lot of use out of these and getting other Hoka style shoes. All right, we'll see you on the next video. Have a great Hoka One One day. Take care.